Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to another video of UberEats clone, and in this video we are going to do the integration for the authentication and how we are going to initialize the session for our React app. So what we have done in the last video is we were able to do the sign in with Google, and we already talked about different auth providers, auth 0, next auth, authentication with the Firebase, and different providers which can provide you the authentication solution. I mean, you don't need to build authentication service. You can just use a Firebase at the client side or auth 0, and at the server side, you just need to validate the token, right? And we also adopted that logic. We are now providing the sign in with the Google. Here in that case, we are still using our auth service to synchronize the data in our database and then create our own custom from the auth service. But here is the challenge: is now we have moved away from returning the token to returning the cookies. So let's say if you are entering the username password or you are doing a login with Google, what we are doing in the response, we are sending the cookies having refresh token and the access token. That's it. And that cookies are also HTTP only. This is really important. Why? Because these cookies cannot be used in JavaScript code. They can be only sent to the server from the same domain or subdomain. They can be only exchanged. You cannot access, you cannot set the expiry and all. So these are the HTTP only cookies which we are sending from the server side. When we are doing a simple login, credentials are correct. We are just setting the cookies and sending it to the client. So cookies are the data which can be exchanged on the network. If the client domain and the server domains are same or the subdomain, once the cookie is set, in each and every further request, that same cookies will be sent. Now the challenge is, how should we initialize the session in this React app? What I came up as a plan is how to do it. We are going to write a simple, you can say, custom hook. Here we are going to write a custom hook. What that custom hook will do is, it will always check the user session. Whenever you go to the landing page or whenever you switch to any route or reload the page, it is going to use this custom hook to call a particular endpoint. And what that endpoint is? That endpoint is nothing but a simple give me my profile endpoint to the APIs. So what this endpoint is, okay, profile API v1 users and profile. So let's say if we have this token in the cookies, if we already have a token in the cookies, that means when I execute this custom hook, I would be able to receive the data back, right? The data contains the user profile data. This API response will contain the user data. And if we have a user data, that means we got the session initialized. Right. So this custom hook we need on every, at the root level, at the top of the component, that will be gets executed once you go to the landing page, once you change the route, once you reload the page. This custom hook will blindly go and try to fetch the profile data. If you have the cookies data already there, then you will get the session initialized. Otherwise, it will just throw unauthorized and it won't do anything. It will take you to the login page if you are reloading from the profile page. Okay, and we can add a context. Here we can have an app context created. I'm talking about the React context. And inside app context, we can feed this data. I need to move this arrow from here to here. So this is the app context. In the app context, we can initialize the data, like, okay, what is the current user data, which contains the email, some username, first name, past, first name, full name, first name, last name, and all these basic information which we can show on the user profile section. Okay, this user is logged in user and user session exists. So this is just a app context root level React context where we can persist some of the user information. It's like a a small redux container we are going to create on top of all the components, right? So custom hook will always trigger. It will set the data inside a context. Okay. And let's say if you are doing a simple login page. This is about login with Google. Once you do the login with the Google, it will take the consent and then you will redirect your to your home page. And we already know that custom hook will get triggered. It will fetch the data and cookies has already been set once we get the redirection from the APIs for login with the Google. Okay, let's say we are doing a login with the username password. You enter username password, click on to the login. We are not going to do anything with the response return from this API because we are not getting anything. We are getting the cookies, access token and the refresh token. So once the login is successful, we are going to trigger, we are going to call this custom hook method. I mean, we will just call this user profile APIs, the same API we are going to trigger. So let's say login with a username password. What it will do is it will return you the cookies. So what it will do is it is going to return you the cookies. And if we have the cookies right after getting the success from the login with the username password, I will make an API call. Okay, give me the profile. So my call will be the API v1 users profile. But this API will check, okay, if you already have the cookies set, if you have a valid credentials entered, your cookies are already set. I will just make a call to this API and it will give me the user data of current logged in user. So it will give me user data and my session is initialized successfully, right? The same thing we are doing here. When you are doing login with the Google, what we are doing is Google is showing you the consent screen, then Google is hitting your API callback route, and through the API callback route you will send a response.redirect to the front end landing page, and that landing page will trigger this custom hook. And we already have these cookies which are HTTP only already set on the domain. So we are just using this custom hook. When you redirect to the landing page of the front end, it already has the cookies data, cookies, I mean token inside access token and the refresh token. It, you just blindly call this API v1 users profile. You have the cookies, so you will get the data. Your session is initialized in the app context through this hook, and we have the data. This is how the whole app session gets initialized, and we got the data whatever we need from the APIs, right? So this is a simple smart flow. This is how you can have your secure cookies. You don't need to deal with the cookies at the client side. You are not storing your cookies or anything inside a local storage which can be exposed. Everything you are capturing through the cookies which are HTTP only. You are just fetching that cookies and just making your call, and that call is already carrying these cookies inside your cookies. And at the API side, we need to change one mechanism, okay? Capturing token in auth guards and all. We would do from the cookies now. Earlier we were doing it from the header, right? There is an authorization header. Now we will start doing it from cookies. That's the only change we are doing at the API side. Okay, I will validate the cookies coming inside the cookies. If cookies are valid, I will initialize. I will know, okay, user is valid. Give the user profile data, current logged in user profile data. So same thing we are going to orchestrate in this video, and let's see how it works. But this is like this is a common problem, and people often get confused how to now initialize the session, because we are getting only cookies. If you are getting something inside a response object of this login call, what you will do is you will put that inside your authorization header, or you will store that inside your redux state, and then each and every call coming from the client will capture the data of access token from the redux state and will send it, right? Here we are checking the user session right after you logged in successfully. Okay, we are not initializing the session based on the response coming from the login API, because no response is coming. We are just getting the cookies set. Okay, So how we are going to do, we need to create this custom hook and the app context, which is going to manage the data. And we need to write these different integrations for the login, register, and the logout. And when you do the logout, we will just set these cookies null from the server side. That's it. So let's open our code. And what we are going to do at the root level, we are going to use this particular hook, which gets executed every time. So we need some hook. I will do is inside src, I can create hooks. Here we are going to create a user context. Okay, so we'll create a first user context. User context dot ts, and user context is some simple React context. What we can do is simply import. I'll just zoom this a little bit. Import create context from React. Okay, and what else we need? We just need to define some interface. Okay, I mean, what is the type of this context? Context type, export type, user context. And you will define all the things which you are going to put inside your context. It will have a user payload. Okay, then it will have a set user, which will take a user input and going to return void. Here we are creating a type for our context. Is loading is a boolean. And then here we will create a context, export const user context equal to create context, and we'll just pass the types. Create context in our context is initialized with value null, and what is the type of this context is user context type or null. So this context, this is how we create a React context. Now we can create a, we can use this context and set these, call these methods set user and set the user data and all inside the context. So let's see how we do it in our app.ts. What we will do is we are going to put a user context as a provider. So here let's say user context dot provider. Every context has two things, provider and consumer, right? So we are putting the whole application component inside this user context because this is the root level context we are setting. And value, we are going to define what all values we are putting inside this context, right? It can have methods, it can have some state data. Now we are going to create our hook, which is okay, fetch user. Let's say here I'm going to call fetch user.ts. It's like a custom hook we can create. And how we create a custom hook in React, export default function. It's like a simple function. Okay, it's like a fetch user. This is the hook name. And here I'm going to initialize some state which we can set, like user set user. And that is using use state null. Because this hook should return me something, right? It should return me the user object and so should expose some methods to set the user. And const is loading, and you can set the loading false, loading true and false. And this is use state, loading is currently true. And then this is the custom hook, so we can use effect. Inside use effect we are going to make a call. So here the dependency is empty. Here we are going to make a call is fetch user. Okay, we cannot just directly write async method. Here what we are returning is, from this we are going to define async function find user, sorry, fetch user. This is the function we need to define, which this is calling fetch user. And now what fetch user is doing is simply this dot axios, sorry, fetch user is going to use axios await axios dot get. Okay, let me import axios. I was thinking why it's not supporting this, because we haven't imported axios. Okay, now we can simply do is axios dot get, axios dot get, and here we are going to hit an API URL which gives me the profile data. Axios dot get. Async function await, and here I can do dot then. So here it is going to give me the response object, which let's put a type any. And once we receive the response, we can just do a couple of things. Set user, whatever the user you have received from this response.data, right? Set loading, false. And here we can just, if there is an error, while making this API call, let's say you are not having the cookies and you are making this API call, so set loading is false. A simple logic, right? So this is a simple fetch user hook we have created that always going to make this API call first, because there is no dependency. So whenever you reload the page or go to that landing page, it is going to make this API call. Here the API URL will be API v1 auth, sorry, users profile. We will see what is the API URL from our API docs. This is going to fetch the current user profile based on the token inside the cookies. And after this, we can return some properties from this this custom hook. So we are returning user object, we are returning isLoading property, and we are returning setUser method to set the user. Okay. So this is our hook. We have the context. Now, how we are going to use this context and this hook? For that, we are going to create use auth hook. Another hook we are going to create, use auth.ts. And what it is going to have, the same thing, export default. And here, export default function, use auth. And here we are going to define a couple of methods like login, register, and set user context and all. And from this context, we can get the different methods. So this is a use context. This is how we access the context. So here I'm accessing user context, which is of type user context type. User context type. And there can be error also. So we can just use that here, set error, const error, and set error. That we can initialize using use state, and that is initialized with null. Why there is a caps lock on? Okay. Now here we are going to define a couple of methods which we are going to expose through this hook, this custom hook, because here we need to export something. This is the bare bone structure. Let's say the login user. What login user is? Some function, right? So here I will write const login user, and what login user will do is, it is async function. Right, it is going to make an API call. So here we will be getting some data. Let's say data is of type any, or data is of type some interface which contains email is a string and password as a string. Okay, this is the type interface we are getting. Here I will extract both the properties from the data, which is email and the password, and then I just need to call that particular API where I can send this data. So here return exios.post. We need to have an API URL, and with that API URL, what we are sending is we are sending these properties. We can just pass simply data. If everything is good, that means we are able to process the API request and login it successful. Then I'm going to perform some other actions, and what these other actions are, await, we are going to call set user context, because here we did a login, we didn't receive any data, it's just all we are getting the cookies, and the set user context is something which is going to be executed right after you do the login. So here we can just call this method const set user context, and what this method will do is this is again going to make an API call that is we are doing only after setting the session, because we already got the cookies, and now I can make an API call after this to make another API call set user context, and it is going to make another API call which will help us to set the data. I will just put it here. So here we have set user we are getting from the context. That user we are going to trigger whenever we got the data from the API. So this auth user profile, we need to also set this data inside a root context, global context. So we are calling set user, and navigate, we can use this React router use navigate hook to navigate to a particular route. Use navigate, I can import. Okay, simple. Use auth is just another hook. Now with the login, we can also create another things like logout user, register user. I will just add them. So this is logout user, this is login user. Inside this login user, we are making this API call to this payload. Okay, so here we are passing data, and then dot then. Okay, that is a login user, and then there is something like register user. Same API call, so I will just add it here, right, directly. Register user, we are passing these username, email, password, and we are calling this API. Here the API will be different. I will talk about this API. What is this? So this is a proxy gateway URL, you can see. And here I'm saying auth register. Here I'm passing the payload. Dot then set user context. So whenever you are doing a register also, we are calling set user context, but here we are not setting the cookies, just after doing register. So you don't need to do anything, you just need to redirect user to the login page after doing registration. Here we are doing set user context because we did the login, we got the cookies in the response header, and now I can call this method set user context. That set user context method is going to make an API call, here you can see, to the profile. Here it is calling, making an API call to your user profile and getting the data and setting that data in the global root context. You can see set user, whatever the data we have received, and I am navigating you to the /, that means home page from the login. On the home page, we already are showing the information stored inside the context. So this is our simple user context. Here we can call set user, loading and user object. All these properties are available inside our context. This is how we are configuring all different APIs, login user, and then now expose these also, register user and login, register user and logout. Okay, just a plain and simple. And what we are doing here is inside app.tsx, here we are going to use this particular hook, fetch user hook. So what fetch user will do is it will give us all this data. So TSX, this is my component, right? So here I will say is, and here is fetch user. This is the hook name. Simple, right? This fetch user is something which will execute when you do the reload or reroute to a landing page. We will get all these properties, user, set user, and is loading, and we can pass all these property in our root context. We don't need to define these methods outside inside this component. This would be one more braces we need, and now it's good, right? All these properties we are directly getting from the hook, use fetch user hook, the user, set user, and loading. And this is how we can set the data for our context, right? Now you can call the set user to update the data inside this global context. So this is how we got the data. We are just calling the fetch user, which is making API call. We already have a cookie session, so it will give us the data, and that data we are sending to the user context provider. So now at the application level, anywhere you can just do use context, user context, and start accessing the data, state object data inside this this simple context. Okay, now what change we have done at the API layer, we can also talk about it. Okay, accessibility strategy, here you can see, I can show you the code diff. So here you can see earlier we were extracting the data from bearer token. Now instead of that, we need to get the token from cookies. This is what we are doing, extract JWT dot from extractors, and then inside this cookies we are getting the access token. That's it. It's like access token is not an object, it is just a string value, so we just need to return it. Okay, and we have this fetch user app.ts. This is how we are calling this hook on the application load, which will give me the current logged in user, set user method, and is loading property. Okay, so now what we are going to do is define the things for this context. So now let's see what is happening inside the code. Here these are our three different hooks, right? Fetch user, which gets executed on the page load, getting our profile. If we are passing the cookies and cookies are set, okay, then use auth. This is just providing a different API methods like login, register, and the logout. And post login, it is setting up the user context by calling the same auth profile method. You can see here it is calling this auth service user profile. This is a proxy gateway route, and then this is we are talking to the user service to fetch the current logged in user. And by doing this login user method, by this API call, we already set the cookies. It is just going to fetch its own profile based on the session and navigating to the landing page. And here it is also doing a set user. Set user means it is setting the data of that current logged in user in the global root context. We are already using React context APIs that it is setting it, and here it is navigating to the home page. So set user context we are calling just after login, so that on the front end we can change the status and show you as a logged in, not just like, okay, you still need to log in. So this is fetch user, and this is your user context, empty, just a one liner. Now inside of sign in, what we are doing is when you are doing a click onto this button, login with a Google, we are taking you to this route, HTTP route, right? And then there is a redirect callback API route, and that is sending us to the front end with the cookies already set. So once it is sending us, it is going to make this fetch user API call, and it is going to set the context. You can say set user. Set user is coming from set user we are exposing, right? Set user, user is and is loading, and you can see all these three properties I am passing back to my context. So whenever you get the user, set user, and loading, same properties I'm passing here. Either we define those properties inside this component, and or we are just passing the same user object here, that is inside a React context. If you are setting user here, the same user is available application wide. So what is happening when I'm just doing a login with Google? It is giving me this consent screen, and then it is taking me to this simple screen, right? What is happening is now I should have received the cookies application, and you can see there are two cookies, HTTP only, and this is the cookie value, right? And now if I do the logout, I'm setting these cookies empty, or just set the expiry of the cookies to zero, right? That is how you can set the, you can expire the cookies. Now I need to log in again. So if I do a login with the email and password, what is the flow for that? Here we go to the sign in. If you are doing a simple form and doing the submit, then you can see this is how we are doing it. We are just calling this login user, passing the email and password from this simple React form, which is capturing the value using use state. You can see the login and password. Here we are passing the email. There is an email and password, two different properties for the two different field, and we are submitting this sign in. So login user, what this login user is doing, if you see our user auth, login user is doing a user login and then calling the set user context, which is going to set the user data. So what this is doing is it is making another API call to fetch the user profile and setting that user profile to our React context. So if I see this demo, how it looks like, I'm just going to do simple invalid password. Then I think it is going to say add request, right? Okay, I need to also showcase like if there is an error, right? If we are not getting the right data. So we need to show the message also. So how we can do that? We can just simply go to our the login page. Inside our sign in page, we should be getting the error also. And here we can do the conditionals if error is coming up. So let's go to the sign in API. Okay, use auth. Here we are doing login user, right? So this is when you are doing successful login. And if your email password is not correct, then you will get inside a catch, right? And here I will just do error. And here we can do a set error. So error.response.data, if I remember correctly. So here we need to set the response. Error response, error.response.data. So if you are entering the wrong email and password, let's say what will happen is, yes, we are getting this message, right? Because we are getting the error object, and if error is there, then show this message, the reload. Now what we will do, we will do a simple login. It is going to make two API calls. You can see, let me reload and show you again. I will do the logout first, and here login. So it is making login API call, which is sending this username, password, and then preview. We are not using these. It is setting us the cookies inside our application tab. We can see the cookies has been set. And then I'm making the API call to the profile, and in this profile, I'm sending the cookies, right? Because this is HTTP only cookies. So whenever you are making API call or XGOS request, these cookies will go by default with your API call. So these cookies I'm sending to the APIs, and there I'm extracting these access token cookies, validating this cookie if it is valid, because this is authorization header, right? I mean the token, access token I'm talking about. That's the only difference is here we are sending that inside the cookies. So APIs will extract it, validate it. If everything is good, then in the profile response, you will get this back. Your email, your first name, last name. So you can use this to initialize your session. You can also get the picture URL if you are doing a login with a Google and all. And you can see this message. So this is coming up from where? React context and who is populating it after calling this profile API. Login is successful. Now I will call profile because I already have the cookies. I'm passing the cookies and getting the user profile data. So this is how you deal with the session management of your React client end side once your cookies are client only. When your cookies are HTTP only, you cannot access them at the client side. You will be just checking, okay, cookies are set, make the API call, fetch the current profile data and set the current profile data in the redux state or inside a context or inside a state, local state using auth state. Okay, so this is the magic thing we are doing, and I will just do the logout, which will reset the cookies and take me to the login page. So if I reload now, it will be staying inside a login page. If I reload this, it will stay on the home page. And if I go to the login, will it take me there? No, right? Okay, what happened? Login page, it is getting the profile. So ideally what it should happen is if you are logged in and you are going to the login page. Okay, there is no login page first of all. It's a sign in. I forgot that. So let's say I'm already logged in, right? And I'm doing sign in. It will take me to the home page again, because in the sign in page we have already a simple check is if user is there, then just navigate the user, navigate the page to the home page. So nobody will be coming to the sign in page after login. You have to log out, you have to reset your user. And how we are doing logout? Here we are doing logout. So we are setting this user inside a context null. That's the first thing we are doing. Because if that is null, that means user has been logged out and we will reset the user profile status. So I will do the logout and this is gone. You can see. Now I can do this again. It is going to make the sign in call and then profile fetch call. Sign in and the profile fetch. That gives me the data which I need. Okay. So this is like a basic session management at the client end side. It's really powerful. We do it in the many different ways. When we are using client-side rendering, when we talk about server-side rendering, then we will be using next auth. And from the client-end side, we can integrate with the different providers like login, GitHub, Google, Facebook, Twitter. And then we can also add adapters like Prisma or TypeORM to persist the data, the synchronized data, which is coming to the APIs. Okay, so this is how we are managing the session. Now in the next video, we are going to introduce the Redux slices, Redux toolkit and slices. So we will see how we can fetch the data of a top rated menu and top rated menu items. This data we need to fetch from the Redux slice, because here we are doing two things. State management is already happening through React Context APIs. React Context APIs is already managing the user. So we just need to worry about using this Redux toolkit slices, and we don't need to worry about sending the authorization header because it's already there on the inside the cookies, and it will be sent automatically once we send a request to the server. Okay, so let's see that how we are going to introduce the Redux slices and what all states we are going to manage. Obviously, I will fetch the top rated menu items. I can also provide some filters on that API search menu item, like, okay, food type, the prices, ascending, descending. And then we will integrate it here. So we will see the top rated, the dish menu items. And I can just apply some filters for the demo purpose. And we will go from there.